I know we have still not shattered that highest and hardest glass ceiling, but someday someone will, and hopefully sooner than we might think right now.
And I can't believe we just put the biggest crack in that glass ceiling yet. Although we weren't able to shatter that highest, hardest glass ceiling this time, thanks to you, it's got about 18 million cracks in it.
And it may be hard to see tonight, but we are all standing under a glass ceiling right now.
At Stone!
But our Commander-in-Chief's highest priority is the safety and security of the American people. And while the last administration too often failed to meet the growing security threats in space, President Trump has stated forcefully a truth that the leaders of the National Defense University have long understood, that space is a warfighting domain just like the land, air, and sea, and America will be as dominant there as we are here on Earth.
Let it go for a second.
There.
Thank you.
That's why I know we haven't been to the moon.
About it for a long time. I used to say, before doing what I did, I used to say, what happened? Why aren't we moving forward? Today's announcement sends a clear signal to the world that we are restoring America's proud legacy of leadership in space. At some point in the future, we're going to look back and say, how did we do it without space? The Vice President will serve as the Council's chair. The privatization of certain aspects is going to be very, it's going to play a very crucial role, don't you think? They are truly into it. I will say that's not easy because everybody wants to be on this board. People that you wouldn't have believed loved what we're doing so much, they want to be some of the most successful people in the world want to be on this board. The human soul yearns for discovery by unlocking the mysteries of the universe. We unlock truths within ourselves. That's true. Our journey into space will not only make us stronger and more prosperous, but will unite us behind grand ambitions and bring us all closer together. Wouldn't that be nice? Can you believe that space is going to do that? I thought politics would do that. Well, we'll have to rely on space instead. Every launch into the skies is another step forward toward a future where our differences seem small.
Why has nobody been to the moon in such a long time?
That's not an 8-year-old's question. That's my question. That's not an 8-year-old's question. That's my question. That's not an 8-year-old's question. That's my question. I want to know, but I think I know. Because we didn't go there, and that's my question. I want to know, but I think I know. Because we didn't go there, and that's the way it happened. And if it didn't happen, it's nice to know why it didn't happen. So in the future, if we want to keep doing something, we need to know why.
Let it go for a second.
Thank
you.
That's why I know we haven't been to the moon.
Listen to what astronaut Pettit
says,
I'd go to the moon in a nanosecond. The problem is we don't have the technology to do that anymore. We used to, but we destroyed that technology, and it's a painful process to build it back again. But the problem is we don't have the technology to do that anymore. We used to, but we destroyed that technology, and it's a painful process to build it back again.
Let it go for a second.
There.
Thank you.
That's why I know we haven't been to the moon.